Over the Easter weekend, I was lucky enough to check out a part of Tasmania that I've always wanted to visit. Join me as I check out the most northern part of the Apple Isle and find out what actually is there to do on King Island. Why don't they have any Easter bunnies? And is it possible that the grass is so clean, healthy and nutritious there, it would give a miniature Shetland pony the strength to carry a 6 foot 22 year old male? This is the Adventures of a Man and a Camera on King Island. Welcome to the main street of Currie here in King Island. Now Currie is one of two CBD areas. Just over here on the map you can see that we've got Currie Harbour over this side here. So Currie is basically the CBD port here of King Island. But also another big area of the island is Grassy over this side as well too. Now Grassy do have their own port, and last night where I stayed is a lovely area by the name of Narra Cooper. Now it seems that when it comes to games of footy on King Island, they split up in between Currie, Grassy and the North. So there's quite a bit of island to cover here. And word has it that 25% of Tasmania's cattle are actually here on King Island itself. So this small island itself contains the best part of a quarter of Tasmania's beef. Now you might look at this and think, oh, this is just stuff from under the sea. This is one of the biggest trades available here on King Island. And you can quite easily earn yourself six figures by being a kelp farmer. Even though it is Easter here at King Island, they are pretty dead set about no Easter bunnies. Maybe Easter bunnies, but not bunnies themselves, because if you bring a rabbit onto King Island, well, the minimum penalty is $500 or 12 months imprisonment. You can go to jail for 1 year by bringing a rabbit onto King Island. I recommend you leave that one at home. Last night I stayed here on the island at a place called Rocky Glen Retreat, and this place is absolutely phenomenal. It's run by a lovely family who have been on the island for quite a few years. And a great part about the restaurant here at the island at Rocky Glen Retreat is they use local produce. So, you know, local beef, local seafood, local items from the dairy, local vegetables grown here on the island. It's a very good way of not only sustaining the island and, you know, the food that's grown here, but also something truly amazing for the tourists. I don't usually eat seafood. Last night there wasn't anything left on my plate. It was absolutely marvellous. When the island was first being settled, well, a lot of returning men and women from the Australian Armed Forces were offered land here at a very affordable rate. They started farms, and a lot of those farms still continue today. When planning your next holiday and you're after somewhere that has lots of nightclubs and places to go shopping, well, you're not going to find that on King Island. What you will find is a place that has so much inner beauty, it's near on impossible to describe. Every 5 minutes you want to take a photo, and the people there are so nice, well, they'd literally give you the shirt off their back. It's peaceful, it's tranquil, it's beautiful. It's King Island. It's a great place, and I recommend you check it out.